In this question, we are asked to factor this expression. And I look at it and I see it's of the form y squared, a y, and a number. And there's pluses or minuses or something in there. So if it's of this form, then potentially I can put it into two brackets. Now, when you're doing this, typically what you want to do is think of two numbers that multiply to the last number and add to the middle number. But when you have fractions, it's a little bit more awkward. What if I had maybe a question like this, y squared, say, plus 4y plus 4? So I'm looking for two numbers that multiply to 4 and add to 4. Well, the numbers would be 2 and 2. But really what you can do, just to check to see if if this is the proper factor or not, is you can split the y. So the y gets split into there and there. So y and y. And then you take the 4 and split it here and here. So 4 splits to 2 and 2. And then you can multiply everything together to see if you come up with the original expression. And then you can say that what you got factored here is correct. So that's what I'm going to do with this one. I'm just going to split it up like this. And I'm going to split that y into there and into here. So this is a y, this is a y. And then I asked myself, what multiplies together to give 1/9? Well, to get 1/9, you could go 1/9 times 1, or you can do 1/3 times 1/3. Usually it might be this one. It could be either of those, but I'm probably picking this one. Let's plug it in. So I'm splitting the 1/9 into here and into here. So 1/9 would be 1/3 times 1/3. Another rule, if this last sign is positive, it means both signs have to be the same. And then this tells you what they both have to be. So the positive says both signs are the same. This says that both have to be negative. Okay, so that's my best guess. Now I'm going to multiply and check. So y times y is y squared. Y times that's negative 1/3 y. Negative 1/3 times y is another negative 1/3 y. And 1/3 times 1/3 is 1/9, minus times a minus would be a positive. And then collecting these two, they have a common denominator, so I can combine their tops. So that'd be negative 1/3 minus another 1/3 is negative 2/3 y plus 1/9, which is what I had originally. Therefore, this is the correct factorization. Hopefully that helps you with how you can approach that question.